Hello everybody,
once again I am back with a new concept, that is may I versus can I. It is going to be really a wonderful one, but so many people I have noticed that they are confused while using may I or can I, or simply may or can. So let's find it out, what is the main difference between may or can. At first, may, which denotes may is being generally used for, it is generally used for permission. May asking for permission. On the opposite hand, can is used for being able to do something. It means it shows your capability. Sadly, all are not permitted to do everything. At the same time, on the other hand, everyone is not capable to do everything. So, let's understand this concept with the example, with the help of this small example. May I use the bathroom? Don't you think so? This sentence is a strange type of feeling it comes to your mind. May I use the bathroom? May I use the bathroom? Of course you can use the bathroom. You are capable enough to use the bathroom. God has given two legs to you to go in the bathroom and use it. You have been taught from your childhood days how to use the bathroom. Then where is the problem? So what if I write here in place of may, if I write can I use the bathroom? Now you tell this sentence is correct. Yes, now it is correct. But if I write may I use the bathroom, it's so something strange feeling. A strange feeling, you know, this is ridiculous. This sentence called ridiculous. It is some kind of awkward feeling comes to our mind. Let's move to another example. I told you already that can use, generally it is used, being able to do something, a capability, possibility. Can denotes action and may denotes permission. Next example, can you fix the bathroom light? Can you fix the bathroom light? I told you it is not possible for everyone to do everything. I will make it clear by giving one small example. Suppose you are in someone's house and you are using someone's bathroom also. Immediately what happened? Because of some damage or electrical circuit breakage, that light is not working properly. So what you will do? Definitely you will call someone for help. So, but you are not capable of doing something. So can you fix the bathroom light? Can you fix the bathroom light or can I fix the bathroom light? So can shows denotes a possibility. Suppose I use may in place of can, then what will be the meaning of this sentence? Suppose I am writing, may you fix the bathroom light or may I fix the bathroom light? I don't think that there is any meaning is coming out of this sentence. May I fix the bathroom light? No. If you are in someone's house, if you are asking, I already told may is for permission and can is for possibility. If you are in someone's house and you are capable enough to do, to fix that bathroom light, problem of that bathroom light, so you can say, may I fix the bathroom light. But here we can say, can you fix the bathroom light? So, another example I would like to make it clear. Suppose you are in a school, you want to meet your school principal. There is an urgency to meet the school principal. So what word you will use? Will you use may or can? If I use can I come inside, it simply means that of course you can come. You can go inside by your own. You can open the gate and you can go inside. But no. So may is more polite than can. So there you have to use the word may I come in. Another thing, suppose if I use can in place of may in certain conditions, Suppose you are in a meeting room. You need to go for toilet or you need to go for bathroom. Means you want to use the bathroom. So at that time, what word you will use? You use can I go outside or may I go outside? Same feeling comes. You are capable enough to do anything. You are capable enough to go to bathroom. So there you have to use the word may, not can. So can means to be action, and may for permission. Let's understand this small but very important concept with the help of few more examples. So we can furthermore understand with help of few more examples. Look at this. A group of children are staying with their mom and they are asking some permission to their mom. So understand this example number one. Mom, can we go outside soon? I am writing here, mom, can we go outside soon? Now you tell, is this sentence is meaningful? No. Because, of course, the same matter comes. I already told, can means to be possibility, someone's capability. Of course, children are capable to go out. So, then what is the need of can by using here? So, simply they have to use may. They have to use may for simply asking permission. Mom, may we go outside soon? Now this is correct. Reply to the same question. Mom replied, yes children, you can go outside as soon as you complete your work. Again, now this sentence is okay. If I am using, I am adding can here. Yes children, you can go outside as soon as you complete your work. Now this is correct? No. Again, if it is the matter of permission, when question has been asked for the permission, mom, may we go outside soon? So same thing, mom is giving permission to their children, to their kids. So where is the problem? Where is the matter of can here? Can means to be possibility. Once it is clear, can means to be possibility. Children can go outside. They are capable to go outside. So this is also wrong. Again, it will come here, may. Now it is clear. Move forward to another example. How many students does fit inside a sports car? Suppose there is a sports car, there is a 4-seater or 5-seater sports car. Suppose there are 5-seater sports car and there are 7 members waiting to get inside. There are 7 members who are waiting to get inside. Now the question comes, how many students does fit inside a car? Suppose if I attach may, the word may here. Now we look at this sentence. Is this sentence meaningful? How many students may fit inside a sports car? Here it is not the matter of permission. Here it is the matter of capability, possibility and action. So in a 5-seater sports car, definitely 7 students or members can't fit inside. So again, it may not come here. We have to use can here. So I am writing can here. How many students can fit inside a sports car? Now this sentence is okay. Next one. Does you spell Mississippi? Suppose I am not well at this spelling. For so many years, I am learning to spell the words very correctly. I am not able to understand the spellings also correctly. So, if I use the word may here, may you spell Mississippi? Now, is this sentence will be okay? I don't think that there is any role of may comes here. May, again I told you, already told you, may denotes permission. So what is the role of permission in this speaking of the word Mississippi? Therefore, it is not connected with the capability, it is not connected with the possibility. So simply, here again it will come can. Can you spell Mississippi? Now this sentence is okay. Now, last example, Dad, we watched television all day long. Now I'm writing here can. Dad, can we watch television all day long? Of course, children can watch TV all day long through day and night. Then where is the problem comes? They are not showing their capability. They are not asking for capability. They are asking for permission. They are asking for permission from their dad to watch television all day long. Again, so here again may will come. So this is the general difference between may and can while using it in sentences or in daily conversation. You must keep it in mind, a small but a very important topic which I have covered, and I hope that you will use it properly.